Eric Johnson, and in today's video, we are going to be back in our driveway setting going over power position. Now, in the last video, we talked about discus throw and how to improve your stand throw. And in today's video, we're going to talk about, again, how to improve your stand throw for the shot. Today, what we're going to do is, when we talked about the discus and we set the angle, we talked about setting your heel toe position, starting from the right, reaching to the left, versus starting from here and reaching to the right. And we explained why. And today what we're going to do is the same thing. We're going to start from the middle. We're going to be able to stretch. And then what we're going to do is we're going to be focusing on our shot setup, and we're going to be getting over, and you're going to notice how I'm pulling, and I'm going to drop down into double loaded legs. Now, well, one of the things we talk about is we're getting on top of the axis, but the implement is not out here. The implement is here. So one of the things we're going to be focusing on is, as we get over, we're pulling that shot out and we're getting down here, and you're going to notice how there's an angle. And so this way I can turn, I'm turning on more double loaded legs. And now I'm going to be able to come up as I'm lifting, as I'm delivering the shot. The key thing, smaller circle, implement sitting on top of us. We want to be sitting over the axis the same way, but we want to see more of this so we're deeper on the legs. I think that's going to be one of the key things. A couple of simple tips for improving your shot. We get a number of our athletes we see kind of struggle with this. Remember, the shot carry for the rotational shot is higher on the neck because you're coming through and you're keeping here. You want that thumb down, elbow up. You're always here. If this drops, you get kind of this position. You're going to lose that striking ability. You're going to lose and disengage the pec. When I keep the thumb down and the elbow up, I'm going to hit that pec more, and that's the bigger muscle, and that's going to help me strike the shot. When I do this, I disengage the pec some, and I'm going to start using more delt, and the delt is clearly a smaller muscle. We want to use that big pec muscle, and we want to have the back engaged. Now, the other thing is we want to make sure that we have the shot elbow behind you. So you need the scap here. So if you notice when I'm here, if you're looking from this camera angle, you shouldn't see. If you're looking from this side, you can kind of see where my arm is. This is where you get some kids too. The elbow comes forward and it drops down, and then they're trying to do this, and now you're right in that position we just talked about that you don't want. Thumb is coming up, elbow's dropping, and you're not getting the same type of strike, and you can't get your hips. Usually at this point, when this drops, it's going to disconnect. We need to be able to keep this back so it's easier to feel the right position here. When we're here, we're going to deliver the intuitive response, right? The reaction is, if I drop this, I'm going to try to go, because you can intuitively kind of sense I can't get much on it. So you're never going to get your lower body ahead to be able to strike the shot. Those are a couple of your key tips and some differences. So remember to focus on getting the scap back so the elbow sits behind, and you're going to notice this position, right? See, so if I'm here, notice where the elbow is. We'll avoid this, and don't get here, up and back, and that's going to be a big thing. So as you set in, if you're a little inflexible, feel your scap pulling back in. This is why you see some of the world elite guys, and they're super muscular and really powerful dudes. So they got big muscles, and they're going to take that shot, and they're going to use their other hand to kind of push it back and get it in the right position in the neck, and that's what you're going to see. What we would again recommend is, when you're here, get that shot, get over, get the shot out, and feel yourself again on one leg so that you're going to be able to drop onto double loaded legs. You're going to be able to pivot and push and drive the hip to the toe board, and that's going to feel that nice position, and that carries over to your full throw. And remember, that's the point of a stand throw. There are some things you can do that will teach you to use the legs and potentially add more distance to a stand throw, but you're not using the legs the same way you are in a full throw, and therefore it's going to train a different pattern. And our philosophy is, you want to always train the pattern that is going to carry over and translate to your full throw so that you're going to pick up more distance on your full throw. And that's our goal. Okay, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed that video. If you have any questions, throw them below. Things you'd like to see. Hopefully you are enjoying our driveway drills. Again, stay strong, stay healthy, and we will see you on the next video.